some people who have wild imaginations say that what we're building right now is dangerous. It's very captivating to the imagination, but it's not very based on the science. At Vicarious, our mission is to build the first human-level artificial intelligence and use it to help humanity thrive. Artificial intelligence will be bigger than the internet or any previous invention that's revolutionized the way the human race works. If 40 years from today, Vicarious hasn't created human-level artificial intelligence, I would be very surprised. I would also owe one of my friends a drink. My name is Scott Phoenix, and I'm co-founder at Vicarious.
Well, folks, what else can I do to make your day more comfortable?
When I was 10 years old, I saw The Jetsons, and I was blown away by Rosie the Robot.
You've done it all, Rosie. What makes you so terrific anyway?
I'm programmed to be user-friendly.
I imagined a world where there were a billion or 100 billion Rosie the Robots everywhere, helping us to accomplish our greatest visions for what society could be. Now, here we are in 2016, and we have Roombas vacuuming our carpet, but where's Rosie? If you can have a computer with the same inventiveness and the same abilities that a human has, you can ask that computer to invent all the things that humans invent. All of the problems that have stymied the human race for decades, like curing cancer or inventing fusion power, making space travel cheap, are things that intelligent systems could help us solve in hours or days. For example, artificial intelligence can read every article that's ever been written about cancer, come up with really novel ideas, really interesting experiments that haven't been done yet, and then execute them in parallel without sleeping with 800,000 robotic arms in a giant warehouse. And you'll get breakthrough results way faster. Then the question that follows it is, well, am I 100 years too early to do that? Am I 500 years too early to do that? Or is now around the right time? At Vicarious, when we had our first breakthrough around CAPTCHA, we chose not to publish it because we didn't want to break the internet. CAPTCHA is the squiggly set of letters that websites will ask you to type in to prove that you're a real person using the service and not just a computer program. We demonstrated that our AI vision system that we were developing could actually solve any of those CAPTCHAs that humans could solve. And so effectively, our AI could prove that it was human, at least to these narrow sets of tests. No one had beaten CAPTCHA in the same way, and no one has done it since. But we're not here to make systems that read text. We're here to build AI. We're trying to understand the computational principles that make intelligence happen and put them into a computer. So when you're first born, you're experiencing this confusing cacophony of light intensities being shown to your eyes and touch being experienced on your skin. And gradually over time, your brain begins to make sense of those things and form higher level concepts of them and begin to recognize and predict the world around you. That matches the process we followed at Vicarious for developing our algorithm. So right now we're in the ABB robot lab in Silicon Valley, and ABB is one of Vicarious's large commercial investors. They're a company that we're discussing different applications of our AI technology, how we can make robots vastly smarter and more useful than they are today. Almost every article, it seems like they write about Vicarious, they put a picture of the Terminator machine next to the article. That gets a little old because it seems so radically out of alignment with what the company's values are and what we're building and the state of the science today. Every invention since the creation of fire has had the ability to do things that are in service and also potentially hurt us if we don't use it properly. Being motivated by wanting to create value for society causes us to think really critically about what are the right applications for the technology that we're building and what are the ways that we could use it to help humans most. I think that artificial intelligence is going to be, and already is, a lot like all these other technologies where the first version is a Roomba. Then your car gets a little bit smarter about staying between the lines. And then on the highway, it can kind of drive itself. And then eventually it's able to take you back to your doorstop. These changes are not going to happen overnight. There's going to be a gradual adoption of them in different industries and in different kinds of products, as they have with every technology before this. People will understand the value of this technology and be comfortable with it helping them in different ways. When I pass people on the subway, I think about how can the work that we're trying to do here be of service to them in their life, and in their friends' lives, and in their children's lives, and in their parents' lives. There's always this thread, feeling a deep personal connection to our shared destiny as a species, and what can each of us bring to alter the trajectory of that destiny towards a place that would be better for everyone. If we could build the first human-level AI, it would be the last invention anyone would need to create.